The country's second oil and gas licensing pertains to five oil blocks in the Albertine Graben in the western part of the country, including Ngaji, Turako, Avivi, Kasuraban, and Omoka. The companies are expected to start the groundwork by exploring oil and locating other drillable blocks to bring government more revenue.
What cabinet approved was to for the ministry to go ahead and issue licenses to the two companies following successful negotiations. So you may ask yourself now, what next? Since cabinet approved the issuance of licenses to the two companies. So what the ministry now is going to do is going to do to gazette the two licenses to be issued to DGR and also to UNOC, and also to prepare the PSC documents and also the licenses.
First, government is to issue licenses for 2 years to these companies. However, if they perform beyond expectation, they will be granted more years.
First 2 years. And when the companies satisfy government, then there will be a renewal for the another 2 years. And of course, after those 2 years, there could be another renewal for another 2 years. Because when you look at the area like Kasuraban, Kasuraban has offshore that is lake environment, onshore that is land environment.
Government has, however, put some measures on these companies, including tasking them to find partners who will inject more finances so that the government does not have to spend much on oil exploration.
Because their license is tagged on having a partner. Because as you know, government will, will be getting funds from government coffers. And these funds definitely are risk capital. So ideally, I would want the government not to risk a lot having these funds injected into exploration. So UNOC will find a partner who will now come and inject funds, most of the funds, and in some of the areas, UNOC will be carried over. So we want the partner to take most of the risks.
The oil block in the Albertine Rift Basin was first discovered in 2016 with the large reserves of crude oil. If handled well, oil production is believed to help alleviate Uganda from poverty. Report compiled by Jaliet Namuwaya for the news.